my enchilada roller. This is my cooking show, Feast with the Beast, babe. We in motherfucking Wood Dog, Houston. My boy Danny and his wife Molly. My boy Chef Gabriel Benjamin. Hey, come on inside. Hey,
what's up, good dog? Come on in, y'all.
Fat boy, high fashion. I'm up, thanks for asking. Boy made lunch on my way to the bank laughing. Car service, got the law swerving. Black bottle beast in here, got the bar nervous. I'm forever alive, now that we've established that. Spurs versus Dallas, I'm taking bets with a Mavericks hat. I'm a savage black, but I'm tucked with the lavish
hat. Just gave him Benjamin, my guy, man. Yeah. Finna do the damn food, man.
Every time, made some good food.
Yes, sir. I'm sure this shit. This is two tomahawks. This is wagyu, two wagyu steaks.
Okay.
This is a whole cow rib. Well, this is like half a cow rib, because it really extends out further than that. I like mine, it's not further, but that's how they cut them.
Nice rib chops.
Show them the wagyu and tell them about the wagyu, man.
So wagyu is a style beef originated in Japan.
This cow is a balling cow. This cow is pampered, only eats certain shit, massaged or something, whatever. Tell me.
Rice, wheat, and grain. We'll season all of them the
same way.
The only thing we're going to do at the very end, we're going to put a nice chimichurri.
Tell them about these mushrooms.
Everybody likes a good steak, mushroom, potato. So these are chanterelle mushrooms.
Tell them about the smashed baked potato shit.
So smashed baked
potato. What's that?
So Yukon Gold potatoes, we'll bake them off, and then when they come out, we'll smash them down, and then we'll put a little butter on them, and then we'll get them nice and crispy in the oven. Once they get crispy in the oven, we'll go back and drizzle them with a little truffle oil on top, and then hit them with the little chanterelles on top of that, just to give them a little flavor. And some guys, we got some peppers in here, some nice, some not nice, and some pretty mean. There's a serrano, there's a habanero, there's a shishito pepper. And so whoever's feeling kind of funky out there with the CBD and however they're feeling, we'll see if anybody's feeling up to having a little peppers and so we're gonna do some white asparagus.
Albino asparagus, that's what I'm gonna call them. I'm not an asparagus person myself, right? So, I heard when you're really rich, asparagus tastes good. I'm not that rich. Far from it, because that shit still tastes nasty.
That's our meal, man. Steak and vegetables, and we're gonna have a good time with this.
Balling. Yeah. Balling. Yeah. Balling. If I'm really hungry, you know, I got big hammer, that ain't bad. Look, yeah, this shit is beautiful to me, man. Foodie news will shall agree, man. I don't really get no better than this, man. I think what would be better was like a Japanese wagyu, right?
Japanese wagyu.
That's probably it's better. The step up from that.
So there is no other step up from that.
Tell you, big boy stuff.
The clarified butter is like I said.
It's like pure butter.
Yeah.
So we just like slowly simmer the butter, and then all the milk solids they come out. Yeah. So it's perfect to cook with.
You went to school for this too?
Yeah. But yeah. So please help.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah,
so
you got it.
Me myself, I cooked in the dirtiest, nastiest traps.
that's a different type of cooking, you know.
Apartments and things like this. I'm uneducated, but get your local expert if you can, man. Because there's always things you can learn.
So this, we're using a Himalayan salt. You want to season?
Regular salt, right? This is some kind of...
So this is a
Himalayan
pink salt.
Sea salt.
It's indigenous to Pakistan.
Hey!
Pink sea salt, pretty good.
That's pretty good.
Pink sea salt, it's favorable, you know? It's favorable.
You're not doing nothing in life if you're not using Himalayan pink sea salt. How does a motherfucker
get... It grew off a bush.
A pepper bush. I've never seen a pepper bush in the hood.
No, definitely not.
Where's a pepper bush indigenous to?
Africa.
Wow.
Yeah. Africa, they
pepper bush.
Yeah, absolutely.
Now, I want to make sure y'all doing it right.
Yeah. They
still got the braids, man. This is my guy, Ron G, man, local neighborhood bully, man. And, you know, we just showing up, man. I just want to show you the finer cut. This isn't like a strip club steak that we used to, like the sugar steaks. You know what I'm saying? Or them Denny's 3 in the morning steaks.
No. Next time, we need measurements, bro.
This half the real cut on. That's the Wagyu purple marble. That cow was full.
You right trust Japan?
I can never afford to buy no meat like this,
you
bro.
Can you today. Can.
Yes, you can.
You yes, can today.
I can make you a hot bologna and cheese.
No.
Hey, with the hot cheese.
You don't have to live like that no more.
Nah, man. Bro.
Let him cut it up, man.
You want to hear that nice sear? Put the Wagyu on that. This is going to be a little clarified butter. We're going to drip on top of it just to season the top. See where the butter starts to melt? So it's starting to start to melt. Now watch here. You're going to see a nice crust start to form. The crust nice to form? Not just yet. For the tomahawks, keep them on there about 3 to 4 minutes each. For the Wagyu, about a minute and a half. And then for the veal, same thing, about a minute and a half, 2 minutes. Now we're gonna see. Make sure to get a nice crust on there. There we go. Nice caramel brown crust. There we go. Go a little bit more on that one. A little bit more. Flip those over. Nice golden brown. Butter's the way to go. Let's see where our tomahawks are. How about that? A little more butter. This is just some clarified butter we made earlier. See how soft that is? It's got a lot of pushback. So that's how a lot of chefs in restaurants figure out where you're at. And since it's real soft, it's still in that very raw stage. And you really want to establish that crust. That's why you keep seeing me flip it back and forth over and over to keep it from keep even cooking. Let's go to smash potatoes. It's got the flavor of the beef on there. So all that flavor goes right to the beef. So we're gonna do a little butter on each one of them. And just let it melt into it. See how our steaks are. Oh yeah, we got good crust there. Almost there. So we're gonna flip them over now. Smashed baked potatoes. Season them up. A little rosemary. Check that out. Nice color. Everybody likes a little olives, shallots, and mushrooms. In here. I'm putting it in a saute pan, which that way we can just throw it in the oven.
Got
oh man, you have no idea. These are smashed baked potatoes. Oh. Rosemary, a little garlic butter, finish off with little shallots.
Bowling!
Crispy.
Bowling!
Crispy. Oh, Brontosaurus Rex, dude. Chef fucking whipping it up over here.
Yes, doing a smash, man.
Crispy smashed, twice baked potatoes. Okay. Bam!
All pinkies at 11 o'clock.
Oh.
All pinkies at 11 o'clock.
Oh, a little bam.
Caramelized shallots.
Thank you, ma'am.
Caramelized shallots.
You gotta have the
caramelized shallots. If you don't got caramelized shallots, you ain't smashing baked potatoes, you ain't doing nothing in life.
That's how rich it is. Smash, smash. With caramelized shallots. Boom! With the beef. Yes. Anything less would be uncivilized.
Yeah.
White asparagus. Since we're doing steak, a little broccolini. See, butter's my best friend. So we'll put a little butter. Once they get a little color on them, that's really all you're looking for. You want to season them up, salt, pepper. We have some arrangement of peppers here, and for those guys out there that, you know, maybe they might get a habanero, they might get a serrano pepper, or they might get a shishito pepper. Everything we're doing on a flat top here, just to have fun, just get a little blister on it. I love the hot ones myself personally. I'm gonna put these in the oven for about 5 minutes.
Well, you're gonna bring it out, you're gonna cut it up, dish it out, pair it with the ones, you know what I'm saying, and show my hood partners what it is. That's all right?
Yeah.
That's that Keys OG right there, man.
Yeah, roll that shit up.
Yeah, we about to roll up, man.
I pour that shit, we can try home. But this pairs well with what we got.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Hey, remember when we used to drink 211s and punch on each other?
Nigga, what? Wreck the fucking view?
This is a Faust from Napa Valley. It's a Cabernet Sauvignon. It's more on the sweet side. It's got hints of chocolate, blackberry, blueberry, and it's more on the sweeter side, not too dry. And it's gonna pair well with our ribeye. We got that one. Then we got a Pinot Noir. This Pinot Noir is Willamette Valley, and it's a Commuter Cuvée. This one is indigenous to Oregon, and it's got a taste of blackberry, more of a sugar, dry, not as sweet as our Cabernet, so it'll pair well with that.
Here are you.
Hey!
Big Live on the OG.
Hey!
Coming to a store near you.
What, nigga? He lied. He never died. What are you talking about when he died? He lied. Let's go, baby.
Yeah, we got our own day.
Alright, there we go. That was so nice. Tomahawks right there. We got the veal chops. We got the Wagyu beef right here. We got some broccolini. White jumbo asparagus. Over here we got the smashed baked potato with caramelized shallots and chanterelle mushrooms.
Shut the fuck up.
This baby cocaine. He know digital scale measurements.
Yeah.
Brown and sprinkle diamonds on my food, nigga.
Yeah. Stepping on birds, too live for TV, weapon on blur. 2 months of winter downhill, wide selection on fur. Still got that old AK with the wood stocks. Hop out and turn the whole stage.
This one, this is gonna be more on the well done side.
Tastes like angel tears.
Lord.
Unicorn Lord. Kisses, man.
Lord. 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 Google it, nigga. Remember that
right there, man. Straight up.
Put you on the map, bitch.
Whatever one you say. Say
it. Yeah, I'm certified and you can stand me. Bulldog sitting straight next to my plate of shrimp scampi. A lot of Mason Martin and Medusas. No more Calvins. Too loud, pump a lot of extra bass like a Luke album. Barrel like a trash can. Can't believe I shoot at them. Better pay like they wait before I beat the loot out of them. And I'm just bringing back whatever I left with. Threw down the line like Osuna. Maybe they'll catch this. Yo.
Tastes very motherfucking damn good to me.
That food was trick food. You know what I'm saying? That's how you get a bitch to give you the pussy. Why are you paying for the pussy? I'm talking about $100 steaks, man. You know what I'm talking about? Rare, medium rare to the perfect core. Because anything else would be uncivilized, man. My niggas on a different level, bro. And if you want to support greatness, roll with my niggas. If you want to eat good and live good and look good, roll with my niggas, man. You know what I'm talking about? From the 210 all the way to the motherfucking 713, nigga. Matter of fact, all over Texas, nigga. It's a Texas thing. Let's get it, baby.
Hey, so I hope you enjoyed this Feast with the Beast episode, man. If you like it, smash that motherfucking button, man. You know, subscribe to my channel, man. Like that shit. Leave a comment or whatever, man. And we're going to keep running this thing, man. Remote controller on all platforms right now, man. And by the time this drop, that ballad video should be up. Y'all run that bitch up for me, man. Live over. Shout out to Stag TV. We're doing that thing, baby.